The National Liberation Day, held on January 26th every year, marks the overthrow of the previous government in 1986. Themed on building a country we all cherish, this year's celebrations seek to recognize all efforts posed to deliver Ugandans from dictatorial regimes. District celebrations shall be held throughout the country to commemorate this significant day at the venues selected by the district leadership. While addressing the media on celebrations marking the 38th NRM Victory Day anniversary celebrations, the Minister for Presidency, Honorable Mili Babirye Babalanda, highlighted some of the formidable achievements registered by the government as of the year 2023.
The economy grew from $3.9 billion in 1986 to $49.4 billion in 2023. Electricity generation expanded from 150 megawatts in 1986 to above 1,300 megawatts in 2023. Roads expanded from 1,000 kilometers in 1986 to over 7,000 kilometers in 2023. Airports grew from 1 to 2, and airstrips from 5 to now 13. The water coverage in rural areas stands at 68%, while in urban areas is at 72%.
As an honorary celebration, the government has ever since been hosting this event year in, year out. Differently this time, though, the Liberation Day celebrations this year will have no state visitors, as revealed by the Minister for Presidency, Babirye Babalanda.
The National Organizing Committee has not received any indications of state visitors to grace the occasion. I'll provide an update on this matter as new developments unfold. Most of the presidents have been around, and it is the reason why His Excellency didn't extend invitations.
The President of the Republic of Uganda, His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, is expected to officiate at the function that will take place in Jinja City at St. John SS in Jinja Wakitaka Playgrounds in Jinja Northern Division.
Ugandans, security agencies have put in place the necessary security measures to secure the venue of the celebrations. The Uganda Police Force is responsible for the overall security at the venue before, during, and after the celebrations. However, they are supported by specialized units like the UPDF, ESO, ESO, as well as the Special Forces Command, that is SFC. The program for the traffic will be communicated to you by the traffic police.
There will be medals handed out to 53 deserving personalities. One of the medalists will be the former Chabazinga King of Busoga, His Royal Highness Henry Wako Muloki, who contributed greatly and largely in the external wing of the struggle. Ordinary citizens in Jinja City and elsewhere have been invited to attend the celebrations, and these have been exempted from conducting COVID-19 tests and presentation of invitation cards at entry. Derek Asaba, reporting for the news.